Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java, and this is tutorial number 10. Today we are going to talk about parameters and arguments in the methods. We are also going to talk about the return of the methods. We're going to continue to talk from where we left it in the tutorial number 9. If you remember, we had divided our programs into sub-programs. We have the main method and four static methods which did the work of the program. Here we can see the four static methods. To do the work, for example, the sum of the array. We need the array. We had the problem that these two variables, which were defined inside the main method, couldn't be reached. From the other two methods. That's why we had put them stuck to the class and static, and as the other method are also stuck to the class and they are in a lower class, they can reach to it. This is not the only way. We can pass the data through parameters. Methods have a system so that we can pass them the data so that they can use them. For example, in this calcular el promedio del array, calculate the average of the array, here we have an error. It doesn't know where the array is. The variable array, he wants the variable array. Here we can pass it to the method array. Here it is saying that this method doesn't have this type. We click and it offers to change the method so that it has that method automatically. It writes a declaration int square brackets array. This array here. When we call the method, we are passing this array from here to here. And once it is here, you can already use it here. This doesn't have to have the same name. This could be called parameter array, for example. Parameter array. Parameters go with lowercase. We will have to replace this name everywhere we are using it if you want to change the name. And here we can see there are not any errors anymore. Why? Because now the method receives the array by parameter. How does it receive it? This int array type parameter will be received from here. The parameter is called argument in the call and parameter in the reception. We can do the same thing for this method. Okay, this. Again, we pass the array to the method suma el array, add the array. We pass the array again. And we have to write it here too. We don't have the error now, as you can see. And the last one would be this one. Just the same. We also have to add it here. Here it uses array and scanner too. It doesn't find scanner. We can put a comma here and pass the scanner too. The scanner is of the type scanner. Let's go to the method here and we add it. Okay, as you can see, we don't have any more errors. Let's try it. Here we go. As you can see, the sum works. The maximum is 12. The average is 6. 30 divided by 5 equals 6. Just as the methods can receive information, they can also return information. In some of the cases, it doesn't make any sense. Ingresa al contenido del array, insert content of the array, doesn't need to return anything. But in the case of maximum, it makes sense. We could say that it returns a maximum int max. We want to receive the result of the calculation of the maximum and keep it into a variable max. We could print max equals plus max. Just the same as we did before. Here we have an error because this method isn't prepared to return a max. First of all, because the return is void, it doesn't return anything. If we wanted it to return something, for example an int, we would have to put the type of what it returns, int. When we put an int, then another error comes up. Add return statement, we have to add a return instruction. This return instruction was added automatically. It goes normally at the end of the program, but not always. It can return a value. This time Eclipse wrote automatically max. Really, it's the only variable which can be reached from the end of the program. Let's delete the printing because we're going to print from another place. We do the calculation of the max and we return it with a return instruction. The max will be captured here and it will be printed on the console. The same thing can be done with calcula promedio del array, calculate average of the array. Instead of printing the average, it can return it. Return promedio, return average. We have an error because the return is void. We can tell Eclipse to change the type of return to double. If you remember, the average was a double, because it has more precision. We delete all the printing. And here we're going to isolate in this method the calculation of the average. And at the end, we return the calculated average, promedio. Here we should receive the result. We receive it in a variable promedio average. It says it is not created. We tell Eclipse to create a local variable, and it does. Here I can print the variable. Promedio average equals plus promedio. Let's run it and see. It asks for the numbers 133 is the sum and the maximum is 56. The average is 26.6, 133 divided by 5. As you can see, we have learned that we can exchange information with a method. Not only we can call it so that it does something, we can send him information as a parameter. In this case, we send an array, and in this case, we're sending more than one, separated by commas, the array and the scanner. To insert the content, we need the object scanner to insert the data and the array to keep it. The sum of the array. We send the array by parameter and it adds it up. This method is going to print the sum directly on the console. And in this case, we're asking it to return the result instead of printing it on the console. It returns the result in max. The return is kept in a variable and we print it afterwards. The same with promedio, average. I hope this is clear. They are not easy concepts, really. When you see them for the first time, they're complicated, but it gets easier when you work with them. This is the end of this tutorial. See you in the next one.